Okay, fine, I'll commentate this one, but that's because this is fun, not because of you guys. Anyways, Little Mac versus Game & Watch. An interesting one that you probably have never seen in your life. If you say you have, you're a liar, an absolute liar. Alternus actually sort of sneaking into the PR sort of towards the later end of this previous season. An excellent Little Mac, and definitely the best Little Mac in our region. Currently absolutely going toe-to-toe versus Dingus here. Dingus going to try and go for the edge guard, and yeah, just going to slip right past. Still has the KO punch available, and right now Dingus is going to try and camp it out a bit. Going to try and shoot up the KO punch, which would have hit that platform, but Dingus mindfully jumping out of it. And very smart stuff to Alternus using that neutral B armor in order to get through the up air pressure and also attack Dingus at the end. Right now, very dangerous last hit situation, and Alternus manages to clutch it out in game one. And I'm joined by the man, the myth, the legend, JPS Scabs.
What's good, RK? I have been watching this with bated breath. Are we seeing an upset here? PR'd player versus Alternus's low-tier Little Mac, the legend coming out punching above his weight class.
Yep. As a matter of fact, isn't Alternus also still PR'd anyways, though?
He's like at the
very end, because he kept getting top eights with Little Mac for some reason.
I am absolutely stunned here. His patient play is a perfect matchup against Dingus Joe, who likes to usually do the same exact thing with Game & Watch. Taking the final D, I think, is a really smart choice, though, because, I mean, where you run,
right?
Little Mac, where you run it.
But then, at the same time, this is notorious for being one of Little Mac's better stages due to the fact that, all right, there are no platforms and stuff like that, so a lot of that platform camping that Dingus was doing in the previous game, he will not be able to do it here.
Sure, you're not going to be able to do anything about the KO punch when Alternus has that in the back pocket, but the benefit for the stage for Dingus is basically that, hey, I don't ever need to let you at a disadvantage.
Absolutely.
If you ever get, like, upthrown by Game Watch on the stage, how do you get down as a Little Mac? You armor through something and pray. Are you dead? Forward tilt? No, not quite going to do it. Game & Watch, a very light character. That is a threat. And I think if this man gets the stop without a mid KO punch.
Did that trade? Or... Ooh, just runs in with the up smash.
Dingus Joe looking a little bit flustered right now. Alternus beating him at his own game.
Yep, absolutely.
Armoring through moves, using like fast frame options like the up B out of shields to just get off of you. This is looking like almost a mirror match here, but finally there's the gimp, the up B, a very useful tool for Game Watch on stage, and don't be forgetting about it off either.
No, absolutely. But then in those situations, it's also like if Alternus is going to get gimped, I'm sure he'd rather it happen if sense he was going to die anyway. Living past 100, something like that, it's Game & Watch as a Little Mac, honestly a blessing.
Yeah, it's a gift. That turtle just taking the hit for Dingus Joe. Barely missing right there was Alternus' board smash. 74%, Dingus is starting to play a little bit more defensive, but that's all Alternus really needs is one or two hits, get them into the corner, get the KO punch, and he tried it on the bomb, and it might spell his end. No, great air dodge. Good presence of mind to recognize that's the only opportunity he had to get back to stage.
No, absolutely. And one thing to note is that Little Mac and Bayonetta are the only two characters in this game that have a shorter than average air dodge. So being able to air dodge in situations like that, or rather being able to know the distance in situations like that is pretty exceptional.
Yeah, they both deserve it. I'm good with that. I'm good with it. Specifically those two characters having worse options in the air. Charging up that down smash, but cannot get a two-frame. Now, that's something that a lot of players kind of respect Game Watch a little bit too much in Edge, I feel. Like,
yep.
You can two-frame that recovery relatively easily. You just have to be absolutely prepared with game audio.
Absolutely. Ooh, okay.
That's the wrong hitbox of the uppie. That's so unfortunate. Joe had the right read and had the opportunity to clutch that stock out, but the wrong hitbox has Alternus back to stage, and now Dingus Joe has to get out of the corner. I think Alternus is going to try to hold on to this KO punch if he can do it. What's the option?
Ooh.
Oh, the dash attack. And Alternus was swinging with those jabs immediately thereafter, getting called out by that up smash.
Yep. All right, good stuff now to Dingus managing to seal out game two with a two stock. Question now is where, oh, going right back to Stadium 2. Honestly, I guess that's one thing I forget, which is Alternus really, really likes PS2. And I figure reason is because since the side platforms are so close to the edge, that means way earlier side B kills, and way earlier side B kill confirmed. So if he's able to get like a down tilt to the ledge and able to confirm that into a side B, you can see Game & Watch dying as early as 80, perhaps earlier.
Trying for those two forward airs, but Alternus, good side B to get right back. But how does he recover from this one? Side B again, and Dingus just cannot get lucky with these up B hitboxes off stage. Every single time, perhaps it's proper DI by Alternus, or perhaps a little bit of justice right here, as Alternus saying, listen, I'm the low tier main now.
Yep.
I'm going to get a little bit of luck in the back pocket.
You've forgotten who you are.
Got that top tier privilege and immediately saying, yo, I'm going to use this.
Ooh, that would have been such an interesting situation. I feel like he definitely wanted to go for a KO punch right there at the edge. Wasn't able to get it. Beautiful stuff there. Little Max armored smash is going to be excellent for catching landing. This is one of the reasons why the character actually does weirdly well against Palutena.
Really?
Yeah, way better than a lot of people may expect. Not winning, mind, but definitely has good victories on the character.
That's a low-tier statement if I've ever heard it. It's like, I have a better matchup than you think against Palutena.
No,
I don't
absolutely
win it, but it's better than you think.
See, I think, though, that's the difference because it's like there are some mid-tiers and stuff like that who Palu is absolutely their worst matchup. Or like even high-tiers like Bowser where it's just like, okay, well,
what do you do?
Well, actually, I don't even know if Bowser's that...
it ain't great. Right. I heard a lot of Bowser mains complain about it, Shnigley in particular. And then
true,
you have characters like K-Roll, who Palutena just absolutely crushes.
Yeah. But then, of course, in the top level, you have... well,
yo, did that kill?
Yeah.
That looked untackable, too. Either that or Dingus was just not expecting to just slowly drift off to his death right there. That side B a little bit wild.
Ooh,
to finish it up. Up B getting rid of that KO punch, and Dingus needs that right there. Couple up matches. That's a Dingus special. I swear to God, he calls his character Boneless Mario in the last game. He plays like in this one, where that like multiple up smash in a row,
yep,
and then immediately up B out of shield.
Yeah, it's one of those situations where even though it's a really slow move, what happens is that...
try to punish it.
Exactly.
Yeah, if you try to punish it, you're just going to die.
The end lag of a tilt.
I feel that's the way that a lot of Game Watch moves are. Like, all of them have a very unique animation where it's like two frames. There's one frame where it's startup, and then there's another frame where it's hit.
Yeah.
And then immediately the end lag is usually enough where Game Watch can just up B to get away.
All right, but right now, Alternus a bit on the back foot. Dingus definitely going to try and force him to approach. Ooh, just runs in under with the up smash, evening this up.
Low profile right there to start this
Will
off.
This be it?
No, ooh, Dingus committed low.
What?
That's odd right there. I think he really got thirsty.
No, 100%. It's very curious. I guess he was thinking that Alternus was going to try and mix up in that situation. Like, okay, well, high hasn't been working for him. At least for the first three hits, so now what'll he do?
Why is this an even game?
Ooh!
Still got the KO punch.
I thought he was just gonna wake up and do it. I promise you. But this is a terrible position, and that is gonna be the set.
That was really close.
Good stuff to Dingus. I